Please stand and face the rear of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Joanne died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers. Strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant Joanne will also rise again. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. You may be seated.
A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat at the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all. How will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Jesus who died, rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine? Or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? No, in all these things, we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Please stand. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to the crowds, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. Before I begin, David and all the family and friends of Joanne, I just want to offer you my own prayers, let you know I've been praying for you, as well as the prayers of the parish. We've all been praying for you and for Joanne during this difficult time. I know this one was especially hard because it was unexpected. There was no time to really prepare, which made it hard. And one of the things the family asked was none of them could see them having the strength at this time to give a eulogy at this service, and I completely understand. Instead, though, they brought me a stack of beautiful letters written about their love for Joanne and the love she showed them. I found them all so beautiful and powerful, and they had a lot of things in common. Especially just Joanne's willingness to give of herself, especially for her family, her friends, being present to you, making you be seen, giving herself to you, wherever you were, whatever you were going through. In our gospel today, we always read it about God bringing us up into heaven, how Jesus Christ doesn't want to lose anything that the Lord has given to him, such as his wonderful servant, Joanne. But in a sense, you can also hear it in a mother's voice. As a mother not wanting to lose anything that has been given to her by God, especially her children and grandchildren, the care and compassion a mother shows for her family. And in that, David, I would love to read a quote from your letter, because I think it beautifully summarized what I read in all of them. David said, "She gets full credit for raising our children, seeing to their many needs during their growing up years. As I always seem to be working, after dinner, I would go out to sales calls, and on returning home later, Joanne would be up late at night, ironing our kids' white shirts and polishing their shoes for the next day's school at St. Joseph's as a part of the uniforms required. The next day, she would be up and getting the kids off to school." As I think, David, you're a little humble on yourself there about the sacrifices you made for the family. But we hear who Joanne was, staying up late at night, whatever needed to be done to get you guys to grow up the people you are called to be, to pass on her wonderful virtues, her wonderful faith to you. It's a beautiful calling to be a mother. And in Joanne, we see what motherhood is meant to be, and not just for those she has been given by our Lord, but to everyone she meets that day, giving herself in care and compassion, whatever they may need. I think that should bring us great consolation when we can have someone like Joanne, who is a model for all of us to follow and to live by, especially those called to be mothers. A lot of times, though, when you come to Mass here or funeral service at the Catholic Church, if you aren't Catholic, you might not know exactly what we're doing, especially when we talk about things about purgatory or why we're praying for someone. Or maybe you are Catholic and it's just a part that's always a little confusing. So for purgatory, what it is the idea, using Christ's analogy, of the wedding feast. Christ always talks about going to the wedding feast, and whenever you have to go to the wedding feast, you have to put on the wedding garment. If you ever put on a new suit, for ladies, like a new dress, it can always be hard to move in at first, especially the jacket, I know, for the guys. It's almost like your arms are stuck. And as the night goes on, it slowly gets natural to the point where you're moving freely. That's actually an image of purgatory. The idea that as she moves on to this next life, as she joins our risen Lord in heaven, there's sometimes a period of transition, of getting used to this new life as a baby cries when it first sees the light. And so we give Joanne this last gift we can give her, the gift of our prayers, praying for her that any time that she needs to transition into the next life may be short. That's what we're doing today, giving Joanne a final gift. And as you pray for her, what can you imagine? Where can you imagine her being? What is the experience of heaven? To continue that analogy of the wedding feast, think of a time with Joanne where you had a dinner with her. Maybe she cooked your favorite meal, or you're out somewhere at your favorite spot together. And if I was to ask you about it, there isn't much you could tell me. You actually forget a lot of the details of it. All you know is that when you sat down, it was light outside. And when you got up, it was dark. And you remember that love, that friendship, that companionship that existed at that table. That's the experience of heaven. That's the experience Christ always gave in the Gospels when talking about heaven, of meal, the supper of the Lamb, all these images. And as I conclude, I'd like to finish with the final line from David's letter, which I thought was so beautiful. "She always supported me through thick and thin, in ways too numerous to mention. As her health started to decline, I considered it a privilege to attend to her needs." That is a love of a husband. That's a love of a couple who has lived so many years together and will live together for eternity when God brings us all together at his table. So we take this time to give her, to attend to her needs, and pray that she may enter into heaven with our Lord Jesus Christ. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his. Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Joanne received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our sister Joanne was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. The family and friends of Joanne seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord. Lord, receive our prayer. We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our sister Joanne. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated.
Spirit, let me bring your love.
Please stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Look with favor, O Lord, on your servant Joanne, for whom we offer you the sacrifice of praise, humbly entreating that, reconciled with you through these devoted offices, she may merit to rise again to life through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Please kneel or be seated. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. In giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Timothy our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Joanne, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Please kneel or be seated. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Please stand. Let us pray. Renewed by this life-giving sacrament, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of our sister Joanne, to whom you gave a part in your covenant, may be purified by the power of this mystery and rejoice without end in the peace of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Before our final prayers, the family just wanted to know that you are invited to a luncheon following the burial. It's going to be at the Community Center in Carmela. The address is 301 Carmela Drive, Mechanicsburg. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again in the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Joanne in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Joanne in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.